We've been seeing the scientific method. We observed how the impromptu speaking is really sudden.
So I
love the spirit they had.
He also described a feeling.
Today's Toastmaster of the evening is Raymond Muhire Cedric. He's known for his energy, for his vocabulary, for his enthusiasm. And tonight we are honored to have him as the Toastmaster of the day with a very interesting theme that he will introduce. Now, without further ado, I would like to welcome to the stage Mr. Raymond Muhire, Toastmaster of the day.
Yes, indeed. Gentlemen and ladies and gentlemen, fellow Toastmasters and guests, good evening. My name is Raymond, and tonight, serving you as the Toastmaster of the day. Usually a Toastmaster of the day in other events is similar to a Master of Ceremony, the MC. But tonight, when you are the Toastmaster of the day, you have 4 hours to introduce the mission of Toastmasters. To present the changes on the agenda. To present the theme, and most importantly, to introduce Lord Takers, who will be taking the stage. And diving into the mission of Toastmasters. Toastmasters provide a supportive and positive learning experience, allowing members to develop their leadership and communication skills, the upshot resulting in greater self-confidence and personal growth. And looking at the agenda, we have a few changes. The timer was to be Rita, now it's Tega. And the accounter was to be Adadi, and now it's Belize Topher. And that's what we have on the agenda. And the theme today is right to the point. It is the scientific method. What is the scientific method? It is a systematic approach used by scientists to understand the natural world. Usually though, it's a bit complex sometimes, but I do believe that there are 3 key steps that you can use to understand the scientific methods. And they are observation, hypothesis, formulation, and experimentation, and lastly, conclusion and communication. In observation, scientists gather data about a problem they wish to investigate. And after making those observations, the scientists formulate hypotheses. A hypothesis is a proposed explanation of a phenomenon, in our case, or the case of the scientists, being that problem they are observing in the world. And then design experiments to test that hypothesis. And then the data obtained from the experimentation is used to conclude whether the hypothesis is to be accepted or is to be rejected. And they communicate it through research papers, through seminars, through workshops, you name it. If you've been in academic settings, you are familiar, acquainted with all those communication channels. Now, how does it link with Toastmasters? Usually Toastmasters aims to enhance the public speaking and leadership skills of individuals. The Toastmasters program does not align with the scientific method, but I can draw a loose analogy to show how these 3 steps of the scientific method can be applied in Toastmasters. For example, I might observe that I have nervousness while talking in front of people. And upon hearing that Toastmasters help people to become better communicators, I can hypothesize that practicing with prepared speeches and engaging in impromptu, unprepared speaking exercise will help me to become less nervous. And then I will go ahead and experiment with those 2 activities in Toastmasters. And then I will be given a feedback by members in Toastmasters, and most importantly, make a self-evaluation and see whether I've been able to overcome my nervousness while speaking in front of the audience or not. While this example is not a perfect fit, but it highlights how Toastmasters can follow a similar method the scientific method, of course, to help them improve their public speaking and leadership abilities. And indeed, tonight, we will be seeing more Toastmasters-related examples that align with the scientific method. While I was speaking about a not-so-perfect fit, it is time to mention what perfectly fits. And that perfect fit is indeed bigger. It is bigger than stupendous. It is bigger than mesmerizing. It is bigger than exhilarating. Bigger than real. Real. Oh, yes, indeed. However, it is not bigger than general. Therefore, that generally perfectly fitting for the session tonight is the general evaluator. The stage is all yours.
Thank you. And I thought you were going to disdain those verbals. Okay. My name is Ivan Eje, and tonight I am the general evaluator, as I said. And why do we have general evaluators, or simply evaluators, in Toastmasters meeting? Someone once said, it was asked, that if you had a friend who shares all the memories you have, all the experiences you've had, like another double of you, and would you be a friend of that person? It was so tricky, but when you look at it, you wouldn't be happy to have such a friend. A friend who knows everything you have done and who is not afraid of telling you that. That friend would not be pleasing. And that's what evaluators do. We tell you what is in a natural way. We tell you what you are doing. We don't tell you what's wrong. That's not our job. But we tell you what is. And tonight, I have a very big team that is going to be working with me. And I would love to welcome them on stage. A round of applause as they come on stage. Keep clapping. Okay, let's start with the timer. They're going to explain their roles. The timer is going to be followed by the grammarian, then the R counter, and the hack master. Then they give it back to me.
Thank you very much. I do not know what this does, but okay. My name is Daniel Tega, and I'm going to be the timer of tonight. Once I was in a speech contest of Toastmasters. There were 10 contestants. One of them lost the contest because of exceeding time allocated. My bad. I'm not here to terrorize you, but that's the reality. We have 3 speakers tonight. I would like to focus mainly on them to make sure we have a proper usage of time. The first speaker will have 5 to 7 minutes. Note it down if you're the first speaker, 5 to 7 minutes. The second speaker will have 2 to 4 minutes. And then the third will have 5 to 7 minutes as well. I have 3 cards to make sure I control time in the room. If I raise this card, you have used 50% of your time, 75, and then 100%. In Toastmasters, we have 30 seconds of grace time. So you can exceed the time allocated only 30 seconds. If you exceed 31, you're disqualified. It's not a contest, but we should prepare ourselves to the next level. I rest my case. Thank you very much.
Good evening. My name is Irakoze Pascaline, and I'm so pleased to be your grammarian tonight. So the role of a grammarian is, first of all, to bring the word of the day. It's written there. It is sublime. Yeah, not sublime, please, sublime. And it means of great excellence or beauty. And an example might be, Mozart had a sublime piano concert. And I hope to see you using it like throughout the meeting a lot. And also, another role of a grammarian is to track the usage of grammar throughout the whole meeting. So I'll be coming here with a report of how we used the grammar well or where we need to improve. And before I leave the stage, I want to emphasize on something. Please pay attention on the usage of R and L. Differentiate those things. I know it's hard, but I don't want to come back after the meeting reminding you that while I had to remind you like before the meeting. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, good evening. It's always a pleasure to be here. My name is Abelise Shini, and I'm going to be the accountant of this meeting. There is this way you're trying to formulate a sentence in your mind, and it's not coming that easily. So you have to use some repeated words like, you know, so, or you use the filler sounds. So the role of an accountant is to note those overused words and those repetitive unnecessary words, and later on bring the report. And another role of an accountant is to recommend each and everyone to take a pause if the words are not coming that easily, if the sentences are not being formulated that easy. So ladies and gentlemen, that will be my role tonight. I wish you a sublime meeting. Thank you so much. Who am I going to call again? General Evaluator? Hackmaster of the day. Yeah.
Good evening.
Good evening.
My name is Epiphany. I'm the hackmaster of today's session. The role of a hackmaster, if you are new, you may wonder what's the role of a hackmaster. The role of a hackmaster is to assess the attentiveness, of the audience. A man by the name of Frank Tiger once said, "Be a good listener and your ear will not get you in trouble." So I'm here to assess to what extent you are free from your troubles. So as a good, dedicated person, you deserve a present, a gift. So I've brought some gift to the top listeners. So stay tuned, I'm back.
Table Topics Master is going to be followed by the first evaluator, the second evaluator, and the third evaluator.
Good evening, fellow Toastmasters and guests.
Good evening.
It's nice to be here.
It's wonderful to be here.
It's nice to be here. Thank you. I'm Eric Bazirishache, and tonight I'm privileged to act as a Table Topics Master. The role of a Table Topics Master is to train members to organize and quickly express thoughts through an impromptu setting. I will be asking random questions. This is going to give the opportunity to the guests and other people who have no roles tonight to express their thoughts. So I hope you are going to have a sublime meeting. Thank you,
I will be back to conduct the session.
My name is Asent Kizerimana, and I'm delighted to be the first evaluator, and I'll be evaluating the speech of, not the person, the speech of a person called Hirwa Kwihangana Julius. Julius, can you wave to the audience? Yeah, please.
Julius. Julius. Maybe I wrote the first, but the other Julius there.
Who is giving this?
Hirwa Kwihangana Julius.
No, okay.
Okay, thank you. So Julius is doing his first speech in Toastmasters, and we call the speech Icebreaker. He's breaking the ice, which is inside him. Yeah, that's basically it. So I like the title, which says criticism is the way. So I got curious when I read your title. So now I know that this is going to be a good speech because this title is really interesting. And what is expected from an icebreaker? You are supposed to help us know who you are. Basically, that is the purpose, the main one. Forget everything else that you usually see during evaluations. This is your first speech. The purpose is for you to express yourself for the first time so that you can know who you are.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen.
Good evening.
It is my pleasure to stand in front of you, these radiant faces. I'm honored and delighted to be the speech evaluator of our second speaker. He is none other than Jonathan Chuti. Please, Jonathan Chuti, raise your hand and wave to the audience. Yes, please. We have witnessed the journey of Jonathan from when he started with his icebreaker. He did all other projects, and now he's on the third level of his pathways, the innovative planning. Today, he's delivering a speech about a project called Deliver Social Speeches. As our Toastmaster of the day said, in this time, we have to try and see if it really works. And the good thing of Toastmaster is like it trains us for different audiences. Now, you may find yourself where you can, in a party, eulogy, in a ceremony, and you are required to give a social speech. This is what Jonathan will be doing to us here. I'll be looking. He decided there are four types of social speeches: a toast, an acceptance speech, a speech to honor an individual, or a speech to honor an organization. And he chose to do a speech honoring an individual. His title is called Welcome to My Graduation. I'll be checking everything he's doing here, and I come back with a report with what he excelled at, his points of improvement, and what challenges he can do during his other next speeches. To you, third speech evaluator.
Oh, yes, indeed. Yeah, to the bigger than Rio team. Yes, indeed. To the sublime lords that they will take. To the nearly great GE that hates them. But nearly great does not cut it. We are going to truly see what is greatest. Because the greatest makes it look easy. The greatest make it look enjoyable. The greatest makes it like it can be imitated. The greatest makes it worth your while. The greatest entitle their speech, Criticism is the Way, to demonstrate beyond a shadow of a freaking doubt that greatness. Though he's an icebreaker, make no mistake, he is going to demonstrate that greatness. Please welcome our first speaker, Mr. Julius.
Hirwa Kwihangana Julius is my name.
I am 26 years of age, and I was born and raised in a well-known part of this city, Kigali City, in Nyamirambo, Nyarugenge district. My current occupation is serving as a volunteer in an organization called Mind Leaps, which promotes self-reliance through providing educational support to vulnerable youth and works with poor families to fight against poverty. Okay, here I come with a question. How many of you have felt the butterflies in your belly when you first told your crush the word, I love you? Raise your hand if... Okay, obviously not many, because they didn't raise their hands. So, for me, no, first of all, she was creme de la creme. I used to enjoy her smile like wine and her dark, unforgettable eyes. I mean, lips. They were sublime. Yeah. Leah was her name, and I adored her very much. But there was this sneaky voice inside my mind that said, Julius, no way. She can't accept you. She's out of your league. You can't afford being with Leah. Yeah. Expect rejection, period. You know what it is like to utter the words, I love you, for the first time. We all know what it feels like. I didn't tell her, because I was deadly scared to reveal such a truth. So I loved her in secret. And I can assure you, it was a torture. But wait, stay with me. That was not all. That was not the worst part of all. A couple of weeks later, after we had become friends, someone came along. Someone else claimed her love and it took her heart away. Do you get it? Can you understand what it felt like? So put yourself in my shoes. Where do you believe such situation, such circumstances would leave you? Imagine if you were to have many more similar other such experiences in other important aspects of your lives, of your life. Let's cut to the chase, shall we? After going through those moments, those experiences, it led me to the realization of something I had missed all along. I realized what kept me in the loop was my fear of criticism all along. It was the fear of criticism. My feelings of inadequacy, low self-esteem, and a twisted self-image. Like now, for instance, I'm standing in front of you, in front of people who knows and do a lot better at public speaking than I do. So I feel anxious. Because I want to impress these lovely, beautiful ladies, I'm terribly uncomfortable about butchering the language they are used to enjoying fish fillet style. I asked myself then, how am I to provide the pleasure I seek to deliver if I'm scared of acting or speaking out just because I'm afraid of being criticized. So I thought, what if criticism is the way? What if there is another side to criticism? What if criticism can be used as an asset? Through intensive labor, I learned that Leah was not out of my league. It was me who unconsciously felt unworthy of her. Then I said, I gave myself an excuse. She can't accept me. She can't. All of those are excuses. There is a great saying I enjoy a lot. People join Toastmasters not because they are great speakers. They join Toastmasters to become great speakers. Going through that process of studying criticism, to help me to understand that people come from different stories. Our perception varies from stories to stories. So then I needed to make sure that I can excel, I can come out of the shell. That's how I came to Toastmasters. I came here to seek productive criticism and building capacity to face that criticism. Thank you.
Yes, he's a great love storyteller. Fond of Lair, he was. As a Brian Nyamirambo minted guy, as myself. To his desire to impress not you guys, but the ladies in the loo, by not butchering the language. As we pay tribute to our first speaker who was great ass in his own right, it's time to pay courtesy to another speaker. Yes. Now, to the picture, perfect right on the money kind of speaker. Not only that, but also to his down-to-earth, pragmatic kind of speaking style. Well, not only that, but also he takes it a step further to monopolize the stage with his genuine calmness on the stage. Not only, but also to his entitling his speech. Welcome to my graduation. To give us that picturesque speech is Mr. Jonathan. The stage is all yours.
Ladies and gentlemen, fellow graduates, Toastmasters, and friends, welcome to my graduation. It's my profound honor to stand here manifesting my qualification. As of now, I hold a master's degree in business administration. Today is a momentous occasion as we gather here to celebrate the culmination of years of hard work, education, and perseverance. We stand on the threshold of a new chapter in our lives. Armed with knowledge, experience, and determination to make a difference in this world. I'm truly honored to tonight to address you all. First and foremost, I would like to express my deepest gratitude to my esteemed mentor, Natasha, who is right there. To my professor, Ange Gabriel. Your guidance, wisdom, and expertise have been invaluable throughout my journey. You have nurtured my mind, challenged my intellect, and inspired me to go beyond my limits. From the bottom of my heart, I do thank you so much. To my fellow master's students, you have been my companions on this remarkable journey. Dear Belistofa, we have shared countless hours of study together. We engaged in thought-provoking discussion sessions, and we pushed each other to achieve our goals. Your friendship has indeed made this journey all more memorable. And together, we have forged lifelong bonds and created a network and talented individuals who will undoubtedly shape the future of business administration, automation, as well as artificial intelligence. I do also recognize you and thank you so much. I would be remiss if I did not take a moment to express my heartfelt gratitude to my family, to my young sister, to my young brother Raymond. Thank you for being my pillars of support. To my girlfriend, words cannot adequately express my gratitude for your constant love and support. She well knows that she's second to none. You have been my rock, my confidant, and my source of inspiration. I love you so much. Ladies and gentlemen, as we step into the next phase of our lives, let us embrace the opportunities and challenges that lie ahead of us. Our education has equipped us with the tools to excel in the realm of automation and artificial intelligence, where groundbreaking innovations await us. To my fellow graduates, I have witnessed brilliance, your passion, and your potential. Together, we can shape a future that is driven by innovation. Congratulations, class 2023. We have closed the finish line of this chapter, but our journey has indeed just begun. And in the spirit of a graduation, allow me to offer a toast to your good health, to our friendship, and cheers to everybody. Cheers.
Yes, indeed, gentlemen and ladies. He holds an MBA, resulting from a combination of hard work on a journey where he forged a lot of friendship and to his undisclosed second to none girlfriend. Oh, yes, indeed, he was Mr. Jonathan. As we pay the courtesy to our speaker, now it is time to see another speaker. Oh, yes, indeed. To his crystal clearness when he speaks, to his sharp as a razor when he speaks, to his diving to the point home when he speaks, to his inspirational zeal when he speaks, to his speech entitled, Motivation is Not Automatic, and right now, to his taking the stage, and his name is Mr. Method, the flow is indeed yours.
I like I like moving, so I'll put this in my pocket. Or should I rather say, I like to move and move it. I like to move and move it.
Move it!
Move it! I can see you have all watched Madagascar. And it's a very cheerful movie, and that's what we need tonight, because we are about to talk about motivation. We'll talk about how to motivate others and how this does not come automatically. Motivation, my friends, is very important. Who knows the most famous slogan of Barack Obama? Yes, we can. Yes, we can. What is that? What is that? What's the nature of that slogan? Yes, motivation. We are going to discuss about motivation, but in the context of a project that we carried out in my club called Kigali Bilingual Club. I will paint the background of that project very quickly, and then I will move on to talk about the lessons that I learned, and then I'll end with a conclusion. As you know, probably, we chartered our club about a year ago, and the year of Toastmasters ends in June. We were about to conclude the year before having a party. And it was necessary. Everybody was dying to have a real party. Not only to celebrate our achievements, but also to be able to motivate everyone in the Toastmasters family. We were busy, but we realized less than 3 weeks before the D-Day that we had to do it. We formed a team, and I was privileged to lead that team. And we were supposed to deliver a sublime party before the end of June. We formed a committee, and we worked on it. And boy, we succeeded. People say that success leaves clues. And if you saw the pictures, you could tell that this party was really sublime. But what did I learn? I learned four important things. First thing I learned is that in order to motivate others, you need to identify what motivates them. What do they want to hear? Sometimes it's a joke. Some people like jokes. You tell them a fun joke. So I had a joke for each individual. And you talk to each individual, trying to make them understand how the success of the club will translate into their own success. That way, people are motivated to do the work because they owned the work. The second thing that I learned is that you need relationships. Not only you need to be friends with your team, so that when you talk, they listen, and they have the goodwill to work with you, but the Rwandans knew it. You can't have a relationship without visiting each other. And in the modern day and age, you have to communicate, call, chat, constantly tell people what's going on, ask them how far they're going, how far we are from the target, any challenges they're having, and how you can help them. So maintain constant communication and encourage the people as you keep working. Third thing I learned is that people need to grow, and you need to help them grow.
How do you do that? Don't give them easy tasks. Challenge them. Give something slightly difficult. And tell them that don't worry, try it, and we are behind you. Or you can tell them, work with so-and-so, who is good at it, and together you're going to make it. The last thing I learned is that feedback is so important that you cannot grow if you don't know what you're not going right, what you're doing well. Therefore, I had to find ways of encouraging and giving constant feedback. As we go along, tell people what they're doing well. And yourself, ask for feedback. Actually, myself, after the project, I did what they call a request for feedback through a 360-degree evaluation. To conclude, we all need motivation. It's important, and it works. Who knows the maker of sneakers? Who is the most successful in the world? The maker, the company. What's the slogan? Just do it. What is it? It's motivation. Yes. We need it, and it works. Lastly, there are techniques. There are things you can do to encourage motivation. So let's all be leaders who know how to motivate our people so that they grow with us as we grow for our own benefits and for their benefits. Toastmaster of the day.
Without getting hurt. Oh yes, we can. Evaluate ourselves in a 360 manner. That is courtesy of our speaker tonight, Mr. Method. Now, we've seen that the scientific method helps scientists to understand the natural world. And though it's complex, we can look at it in three ways, three structured ways. We have the observation, hypothesis formulation, and the experimentation, and lastly, conclusion and communication, of course. Now, let's see another Toastmasters related example of how I mold the scientific method. For example, I might observe that I have difficulty in organizing my thoughts and delivering a clear message in impromptu, unprepared speeches and in a time-limited manner. Now, I might hypothesize that if I can practice brainstorming and structuring my thoughts quickly, I will be able to deliver a coherent, impromptu, unprepared speeches in a timely manner. Then, my experiment. I will engage in regular impromptu speaking exercises. Practice generating ideas quickly and focusing on organizing my thought and see what happens. And now, that organizing thought might be introduction, body, and conclusion. Where if you heard me speak about the introduction, body, and conclusion is because maybe another load taker has alluded, mentioned it in the introduction of their role. Now, to make you, as a member, leave that introduction, body, and conclusion is the table topic master. My friend, the floor is all yours indeed.
Good evening once again.
Good evening.
Now, it's table topic session, and I wish everyone to participate. I have some questions, and you're going to enjoy responding. Let's get started. there are open questions that are going to help everyone to express themselves. And everyone who is going to respond is going to have maximum 1 minute on the stage. You're going to come here, introduce yourself, and go on with your response. There is no good and bad response in table topics questions. The first question is, what is the most important lesson you have learned from a failure or a mistake in your life? Let me repeat. What is the most important lesson you have learned from a failure or a mistake in your life? This question goes to Herbert.
Thank you so much. The good thing about these table topics is we will go, we'll be buying some time with this, as you think. One of the lessons I learned recently is not waiting on a customer. There was this customer who went, who came to us, and we had a meeting, and I had to tell him to wait for us. And when we came back, he had left already. So that's something I learned, and when we tried to call him later, he wouldn't pick up the call. So I learned from that mistake that we shouldn't wait on a customer. We should serve the customer when he comes. Thank you so much.
The second question is, who is someone you admire, and what qualities do they possess that you find inspiring? Who is someone you admire, and what qualities do they possess that you find inspiring? This goes to the lady behind.
Toastmasters. By name of Kisa Ishimwe. The person I like is someone who is hardworking, who is trustworthy, someone you can trust. That's all I find someone I admire. Thank you.
What a book or a movie or a TV show that has inspired you or influenced your thinking, and why? A movie or a TV show that inspired you, and why? This goes to you.
Thank you. My name is Narikajga Elis. What a movie or a book has inspired me, and why? I've been inspired by the book called Think and Grow Rich by Napoleon Hill. And the reason why it inspired me is because he did research for 25 years, and he interviewed all successful people of that time, including Henry Ford, Andrew Carnegie, Thomas Edison. So it inspired me to think big, and it changed my mindset, and I read it like 10 times. Yeah, it is the book that inspired me. Thank you.
The next question is, did Toastmasters transform your life? If so, how? Did Toastmasters transform your life? If so, how? This goes to Natasha.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen.
Good evening.
It's so nice to be here. And truly, Toastmasters has inspired my life. My name is Natasha Mutangana, for some of you that don't know me. And how did Toastmasters transform my life? I got to know Toastmasters after I finished my first year of undergrad. I was traveling and someone told me about Toastmasters. They were telling me, oh, okay, so if you want to develop your public speaking skills, you know, you should join a Toastmasters club. I had not heard of it before, but then surprisingly, I was in KIST, for my KIST, the University of Rwanda, and they had Toastmasters, a Toastmasters club, but I've never really got to participate in it. But after hearing that, I remembered, oh, okay, cool, that's it. But then in my second year, I heard that there's a Toastmasters meeting, so I attended. There, a few people who were attending, they were saying, oh, why do you really need to attend Toastmasters? You speak English. The idea was that it's to develop your English speaking skills. But to me, I was like, I do not know. Let me just try it out. Somebody recommended it. After joining, trust me, I was on this growth curve. I learned that I am not a social person. I was initially not a social person. I could not, whenever I was coming to speak on stage, I could feel the nerves and I was so scared, but nobody could see it. After participating in multiple meetings and taking on some leadership roles, I developed this confidence when I'm speaking on stage. I had this demeanor when I'm speaking. I feel like it's okay, you know, somebody is listening to me. And right now, I'd say I'm implementing what I learned from Toastmasters. Thank you.
What do you need to succeed in life? This goes to Pacific.
Ladies and gentlemen, good evening.
Good evening.
As he said, my name is Pacific. I was waiting for you to say Pacific because English speakers call me Pacific. But well, the question is, what do I want to succeed in?
And what do you need to succeed?
Okay, personally, I value a lot of things. Money, living well with people, and the most thing that I fear, like my biggest fear, is being broke, to be honest. So the greatest success, unfortunately, the greatest success that I want is not actually money, but having a happy life. By happy life, of course, money will involve. But most importantly is actually living in harmony with people, enjoying life, collaborating with people, and of course, in an unbroke way. Thank you very much.
Ladies and gentlemen, and gentlemen and ladies, always the table topic session is sublime. There is the truth. Oh, yes, indeed. We've been seeing the scientific method. We observed how the impromptu speaking is really sudden. You do not prepare. That was our observation. And then we hypothesized that brainstorming fast as you come on the stage and structuring your thoughts really quickly by using a framework such as introduction, body, and conclusion can really help you. That was and our experimentation just happened here. And we can safely conclude that if we were to rate the person whom we would give high marks, now, this is really objective, is the person who demonstrated the IBC structure, introduction, body, and conclusion structure, while delivering their speeches in an unprepared manner. Now, it's time to put speeches for the sake of speaking in the rear view mirror. And the latter gaze on the proverbial windshield as we move at the metaphorical Formula One speed. The speed which is in the form of listening. Listening which implies that you can recall what was said in the meeting, either verbatim, word to word, or paraphrased. Those two methods being highly recommended. And to make sure that they are equally highly appreciated is the Hackmaster. The floor is indeed yours.
As promised, me and Pleasant, we are back. We are here. So I have questions here, so it is not going to be done as table topics. So you'll be raising your hands and for you to answer the question. So the first question, the first speaker mentioned his name, his age, sorry. What is his age? He also described a feeling that someone has before I enter. The second speaker mentioned a few minutes ago, we were in a graduation, right? Yeah. So the second speaker mentioned a field he's graduating in. What was the field? Great. What is the title of the speech of the second speaker? In
the second speaker was
The third speaker mentioned four things he learned. What one only, one thing from those four things he learned. Please go on. Only one thing. No, it's not. It's not. Disqualified. Another one. You. Disqualified. No, I don't think so. No. The timer. Huh? Yeah. What was the third speaker's title? The title of the speech. Okay, it should not be. Okay, let's go back to him. Uh-huh.
speaker's title of the speech is Motivation is Not Commanding.
Ali, the Hackmaster mentioned a quote. What was the name of the author? No, I'm not there. No, I give you. You?
I remember the name.
No, both. Both. No.
Frank?
Tiger. Yeah.
So, ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much. I am now. I'm not sure. No. Session closed. Session closed. Okay, the first speaker, he mentioned, like, there is a way specifically he described the lover, his crush. How was
she was Crème de la Crème.
That was a bonus. Thank you so much.
Oh, yes, indeed, ladies and gentlemen. When I say that this session for people who really understood, either verbatim, word to word, or in a paraphrased manner, will be highly appreciated. Aye. Was right, because the reward speak for themselves. Now, ladies and gentlemen, after observing, hypothesizing, and concluding about impromptu speaking and prepared speeches, now it is the time to communicate what has come through our conclusion. We need to communicate it through feedback delivery. Oh, yes, indeed. So that communicative feedback is to be delivered by a team headed by the bigger than stupendous, bigger than exhilarating, bigger than rayor. We can even go ahead and add bigger than genuine, which is genuine. Yes, indeed. He is the general evaluator. The flow is all yours, indeed.
I was, Raymond's introduction was making me feel offended in way, because he kept saying he's bigger and bigger than this, bigger than that, and reminding me of how I was gaining weight. So I was thinking, is this personal? But anyway. I'm still bigger than him. So he has rights to say that. So I was wondering what could Ange be feeling if he was the one? Man. This week, I was given this job, to be the general evaluator in Ijwi Toastmasters, and I personally was on this journey. I was self-evaluating myself, because I wondered how to make evaluation good. It always feels like it's a list. When you are evaluating, you're giving a list of things. This is what you can do. This is what you did best. This is what you can do better. This is what you have to change, and you have to challenge yourself on this. And it always feels like that. So I had in my mind, what can you do? I went on YouTube, started searching for how good evaluators, what are the tips and the things. And I remember this quote. It's from Richard Bach. It says, we teach best what we most need to learn. So it was like a privilege to me to be the general evaluator when I'm trying to learn how to evaluate. This evaluation session is going to be run by the team. Now we are going to start from the first evaluator. We'll give the floor to the second evaluator and the third evaluator, then back to me. The first evaluator.
Thank you. What a sublime speech that he gave. Where is Julius? There is a thing I liked, but before I say it, please give a big round of applause to our first speaker. Okay, I said the thing I liked, but I liked many things, not one. So don't worry, it was not one thing I liked. So Julius, at the start of your speech, you had a really small unexpected challenge. It started raining. For people who have delivered icebreakers, I promise you when you come on stage, you are shivering, you're so afraid, and something unexpected happens, you can even go back to sit because it can already put you in a different mode. But Julius, once he came on stage, I don't know if he chose to be silent because of the rain, but he chose silence at first because it was raining and people had started to chat. So he gave us time to really know that he's on stage. And he commanded us to listen to him. That was amazing. Thank you so much for doing that. You started the speech telling us about yourself because that's what was expected of you, for us to know who you are, where you were born, and you kept on explaining, talking about you being anxious in your life. And the first thing I noticed, I'm talking about the things which I was really impressed by, you asked a question to the audience, and asking questions is one way of engaging the audience. Even someone who is not following, they start thinking about the answer, even if they're not going to answer. So that was amazing. You cracked a joke, a really good joke, and we laughed. You cannot crack a joke if you are not confident on stage. Trust me, you cannot. That was amazing. You were moving on stage. You're not standing here like I am here, which is amazing. For an icebreaker, there's not too many expectations because they are trying not to overwhelm you with things to use in your speech because it's your first time. But you were speaking for the first time and you managed to incorporate movements, eye contact, all those things that they're always repeating and repeating in, even for level 5 speakers. That is amazing. You just have to work on all those skills. The fact that you're able to use it on the first time is incredible. To improve, so in Toastmasters, we have project title, or the project objective, and the title. We have a title, a personal title for a speech. So each project, we have a different objective, something to work on, to learn. So this time, you had to help us know you on a different level, more than we can know you at the end of the meeting when you are talking. So we had to learn who Julius is. So I like that you used anxiousness as part of something to help us to know you, but you didn't give us a lot of details. We only had one detail about you and your crush, but I would have loved to hear more about you being anxious in your life, so that maybe you could have talked about your family, anxiousness in your family, it could have helped. And to improve, to challenge yourself, you can learn how to use intentional movements in a speech. Moving is really okay, it is really nice and good, but moving intentionally is even better. Moving in one side when you are making one point, then the second point in the center, and then the third one here. So that's something you can learn on your next speeches. Basically, your speech was really amazing. I loved the humor, the pace, the incredible grammar. He used butchering, twisted self-image. That was amazing. That was incredible. Crème de la crème. Yeah, you cannot remember those really hard vocabularies when you are nervous. So he was really confident. I like that. Thank you so much. Back to the...
Our second speaker demonstrated experience in public speaking. Starting with the point of excellence, when he was here, the dressing attire was indeed communicating graduation. Like, we were in a celebration. And that's a very good thing to mention. Like, in Toastmasters, it's a safe place. We go flow like smoothly as you feel. But for him, he thought about his attire going with the speech. That was something of very high interest. He demonstrated sublimity of a speech to honor individuals. That's the type of speech her social speech has chosen to speak about. And he mentioned different people, mentors, professors, family, going to the details saying my girlfriend and every other people. Yeah, that was very good. And the audience was absolutely engaged, and it was demonstrated by the way they were clapping after mentioning each person. Like, for each person, they were engaged and convinced by what you were saying, and they clapped for you. I liked you incorporated actually two social speeches. The main was honoring an individual, but you finished your speech with a toast, which is another kind of a social speech. Those are the points of excellence. Going to the points of improvement you can work on, especially as you are going to do the second social speech. Usually in life, social speeches can be impromptu or improvised. You might be in a ceremony and they tell you to come and give a social speech. So by next time, try to practice without notes. Another point for that, reason for that, is because usually in parties we don't have pulpits. And we're standing like this, using your pulpit as your support. So try to practice without notes or any other support. And as people were honored in your speech, it would have been better if you used gestures to demonstrate them and to highlight their presence in your ceremony. As you could say, let's clap to my mentor, to my professor, to my family, and to my girlfriend. You see, it would have increased the potential of your speech. To challenge yourself in your next speeches, especially the second social speech, you can incorporate aspects of other projects. If it was a ceremony, you could have used storytelling tales. Tell us about a small story about your journey of school. You could have used visual aids or any other kind of aspect of another project. Another second social speech can be mainly of another type because you are sublime with a speech to honor an individual. You can do a speech about an acceptance speech or a speech to honor an organization. And I hope to see more improvement and more interesting and sublime speeches to the third speech evaluator.
Thank you. Let's put our hands together and give it up to Method for such an amazing speech. How many of you were motivated by his speech? The results speaks for themselves. It was truly a motivating speech. And I love the way each component of his speech was connected. It was like everything was fitting into the puzzle, starting with the way he was moving, the dances, because he was going to talk about a party which they organized. So everything was really, really fitting together. Be it the gesture, being the message, being the experience. And I love the way he used the slogans of both people, politician, and organization to show that motivation really is all around us and in our everyday life and that it works. So it was really, really amazing. So the introduction was very cheerful. I loved it. It really put the audience in the mood of the party that you were going to talk about and how successful it was. The gestures and the transition were really on point. I love the way you moved from points to other. When you talked about the four tips, you clearly explained each tip and you went to the next. So we could easily follow the structure of your speech. And I love the way you use eye contact. And on the what you may want to work on, eye contact is a tool of audience engagement, as you know, because you're an experienced speaker. So I felt like you could have used it more to engage it. You commanded the audience, but sometimes when you see that someone is a bit distracted or you're losing him, you can use that eye contact to bring that person back into your attention. So I felt like you can use eye contact more as a tool of audience engagement. But other than that, the vocal variety is really, really amazing. Your gestures were on point, and of course, you're very, very comfortable on the stage. The topic was really engaging and well organized. You really achieved all the purpose of this project, and I really, really congratulate you. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Thank you, speech evaluators. Now it's time for the grammarian, the accounter, and the timer. Round of applause.
I'm back. I was serving as the grammarian, and I'm back with the reports. Now, first of all, the word of the day, sublime, was used 13 times. 13, and it was used by the TMOD method, Mr. Alexandre, the first speaker, the table topics, and the first speech evaluator, and the second speech evaluator, and it was mostly used by the TMOD, Mr. Yeah. And then some grammatical errors. I heard someone who said, challenges he can do. It could have been better if he would have said what he can do to challenge himself. And then sometimes the word of the day was pronounced as sublime or sublime, I don't know, but it's sublime. And then somebody said, berry instead of belly, and someone said crème de la crème. It is crème de la crème, voila. And somebody said productive criticism, not that it's wrong or something, but it could have been better if he would have said effective criticism. And someone said rant. He could have said run. So other than that, we have some take home words. Someone said freaking. It is used to emphasize or to express annoyance. And then someone said momentous occasions. And it means of great importance or significance. Someone says culmination, which means the highest or climatic point of something, especially as attained after a long time. And someone said threshold, the magnitude of intensity that must be exceeded for a certain reaction. There are a lot of them, but overall, I would like to please tell you to keep practicing the difference between R and L. Please work on that.
Good evening once again, ladies and gentlemen. I am back with the report. As I was tracking the filler words and the repetitive words, and as I recommended to take a pause if the English is not Englishing or the words are not coming that easily, what I have on my report is that some people used filler words. General evaluator, is it okay to state the name of those people? Okay, yes. First speaker, first of all, thank you. That was an amazing speech, but you used a lot of as, so I think next time you can correct that. And third type of topic, respondent. I do not recall the name. You are the one, thank you. So you used a lot of as too. And third speech evaluator, Mr. President, you used a lot of as too, and to the grammarian. And as. So I highly recommend to use, to take a pause. Yeah, for example, general evaluator. He took a lot of pauses whenever things were not coming that easy. And also the third speaker, you did a great job. And also to the taskmaster of the day, your speed is really speedy. And you also managed to take a pause or to align your words properly. So ladies and gentlemen, all of us, let us create no room for filler words or those repetitive unnecessary words, and take a pause whenever things are not flowing. That is, thank you so much. And timer, yeah, your turn.
Good evening once again.
Good
evening. The name is Daniel Tega, in case you forgot. Now, I was a timer. Frankly speaking, I don't want anyone to time me right now, so I took the cards. this is my first time to do the role. Not that it is hard, but really, I don't like timing, because most of the time I exceed time. I was the time police in the room. Thank you very much for the opportunity, Mr. President. Now, heading to the report I promised to give, I would start with respective speakers, as I've actually foretold their time before. Actually highlight how sublime the speeches were. I was impressed. Sometimes you want to raise the card and you don't feel like raising it, especially for method. I was driven. And especially as well for with the first speech, I was also taken. Now, cutting to the chase, first speaker, Mr. Hirgua, used 7 minutes and 34 seconds, which exceeds 4 seconds to the grace period, and that could disqualify the speech, just 4 seconds. So let's keep learning, he'll be fine. And the second speaker, Mr. Jonathan, the graduate, he used 4 minutes and 45 seconds instead of 4 minutes. So I gave 30 seconds of grace period and he still exceeded 15 seconds. Disqualified too. Not that this is a contest, but in the contest matters. For the third speaker, Mr. Senabio, please help me to give it up for him, because he made it. My trick was to raise the red card before 10 seconds, and I did it, and he stopped exactly at 7 minutes. Well done. That was nice. And to the table topics master. Oh, you used 10 minutes and 30 seconds instead of 8 minutes. That was terrible, really. But yeah, especially for table topics, it's kind of tough, because you're not controlling the stage yourself. There are a lot of people. So the first table topic respondent, Natasha, she left. She used 2 minutes instead of 1 minute. Next time you're given a chance to respond, use 1 minute. The fifth speaker, Pacific, I would mention that he used 1 and 30 seconds. 30 seconds exceeded as well. Others, they're pretty fine. Some of them used even lesser time. Well done with it. I would also go to Mr. Arsene. The second, the first, is it the second?
First.
The first.
speech evaluator. Excuse me, man. He had 3 minutes allocated to him and used 4:30. It's not a speech, but disqualified as well. That's it. And also the TMOD, he used most of the time well. However much he had so much little time to use. Usually when you exchange the state, the TMOD has 1 minute. It's quite challenging to put your topic in there, but I could grace him with 30 seconds and he did well. Well done with that. I struggle with people with the TMODs. They usually keep increasing your time and we leave at 9. Too bad. So thank you very much. This was well done. There one last thing to the table topics. Make sure you, since you have a lot of people doing the stage thing, minimize the things that you talk about in between. Thank you very much to the general evaluator.
Thank you, my team, for the evaluation. Thank you for the audience. I'd like to start this evaluation by telling you to, in our evaluation, evaluations differ. There are evaluations that are oriented on one person and others are for the whole audience. Two evaluators, timer and the accounter, they are asked to point the names of people because they are personalized. It's you personally who is using time in a wrong way. So it's you personally who has a problem of ahs and ums and all the pauses that are not unnecessary. So they are asked to point out the names. And I would like to start from them. I love the way they took the role at the last minute. They were sitting here and we told them, could you move there and grab these roles, these two roles? And they took that happily. So I love the spirit they had. And there are also two roles that need to record, to keep records, and it's so, most people think it's the easiest. Being the timer is the easiest. That's what people think, but it's the hardest. You are not allowed to follow the speaker. You can't, because when you follow and the speaker is very nice, you lose time. You don't know. So I love the way they kept that. This meeting was one of the best meetings we have ever had. One thing that I saw that she can change, and it is something that we all do, it is when we are addressing a problem or a mistake, and we want to be friendly, then we add this word that kills everything we have said, the word, I don't know. So you're telling someone what they did wrong, then after you say that, you say, I don't know. It's something that we should avoid. You know, when you're going to tell someone what they did wrong, just say it. Don't add, I don't know, it may be, it's like you're not sure, no. Be sure and go. Straight to the point. Our Hackmaster Epiphany, one of the new registered member, she needs a round of applause. One thing I saw from her, and it's something that we don't normally see from Hackmasters, is have you seen the way she conducted all the session laughing, smiling? I personally don't know how you followed, how you got the questions, because I was thinking something else.
Mesmerized.
Yeah. And that, the way she was conducting the session, she was enjoying the session, enjoying the questions. She knew the answers. She didn't need to check if the answer they are giving is the right answer. And
that also, the way she was, the vibe she was giving us, you gave us also the, you reacted to it. It was so fun, there were so many people shouting. If you remember Obed, Krema, I'm sorry. You remember I said how our friends enjoy the way we suffer. Yeah, that shows that he is your real friend. She needs a round of applause. And to the table topics. I love the way he conducted the introduction. It was very clear. Everybody knew what he was going to say, he was going to do. And I love the way when he was on stage, I love the way he was asking questions before picking the respondents, because that made us think about the answers. What if it's me he picks? Then that engaged everyone in the audience. Most people, sometimes table topic masters pick people, choose respondents, then ask questions. And that excludes everyone, because you now know whose burden that is on. It's not yours, you don't care. And something that he did, which is something that also most of us sometimes we do, is the way he was repeating questions. He said a question, then he repeated the question again. It took the time, it stole the time from him, because he used more time, and if we had to calculate, if we had to add up all the time he used repeating the questions, it would, I think it would add up to those 2 minutes, I think. Also, he needs a round of applause. To our TMOD, I love the theme, scientific word, scientific method. It is something that was written, or it's a picture that was drawn by Sir Isaac Newton. Did you know? And have you seen the way his voice was changing? The true manifestation of vocal variety. He had each tone for every word. He meant what he was saying. And I remember meeting Raymond last year, the first time we met. We worked in so many of his speeches together, and I love the way he knew. The first time we met, we were talking, and he knew exactly what he wanted to do. And I have seen that from everything he has done, every law, every speech. He always sticks, he is consistent on his goal. And I really, really honor that. I respect that from him. He needs a round of applause. And last but not least is our speech evaluators. I'm going to evaluate them in general as one, because they were the evaluators. You remember, as I said, I was learning how to evaluate, and given this job, I really enjoyed doing this. I saw something. There are 4 things that I'm going to say that we all evaluators, mostly we do it, but we are not sure that we're not conscious that that is what we're doing. Then because we're not sure what we are doing, we sometimes miss it. First thing, evaluation is a performance. Most people, I was looking and I have seen that in evaluation session, most people take their phones, they check their emails, their messages, and I was asking, why does this happen so many times? One thing I saw is that when we are giving evaluation, we tend to put it in a second person, the people we are evaluating. we put them in second person. So I'm saying, let me give you an example. I'm evaluating Clemmer, and something you really did very nice is the way you started your speech. This is, I'm talking to Clemmer only. And this is what we do most of the times when we are evaluating speeches. We talk to the speakers. Yet, when we put them in third person, we are talking to the audience. And everyone feels like it's them. If there is something the speaker did very nice, everyone thinks, oh, I should copy that. So you are addressing the whole meeting, the whole audience. This is something that Obed did, but in the end, he then went back and started talking to the one he was talking to. The other thing is give examples. When you are stating the obvious, you know, you should work on your eye contact. You should work on vocal variety. We only say that, every evaluator say that. But what if we were to give examples? So when you give example, you show the speaker, you show everyone what they did wrong, and when you correct it, they see the change, they see the results, and they know exactly what you mean. The last thing is to go on same pace. When you are evaluating, just say a few things on one person, maybe two. Some two things he did very nice, and two things he can change, and keep the same pace, and the rest you can say that next time, because you're not going to change the world in 5 minutes. And I would love to thank all the audience. There were no phones ringing. There were no ins and outs. You reacted to every vibe. And I would like to thank everyone. A round of applause. To you. This was the evaluation, the general evaluation. I am Ivenije, and back to you, the TMOD.
Oh yes, indeed, gentlemen and ladies. Well, in Toastmasters, we learn to gain self-confidence, to become better communicators. But we also avoid filler sounds. But most importantly, my friends, we have fun. We've seen the entertainment. Now, to bring further the fun is the Joke Master! The flow is indeed yours, Gael!
I'm supposed to be the joker. good evening. It's nice to be here. It's wonderful to be here. It is nice to be here indeed. So, this is a true story. This goes back to when I was in high school. So I was sitting in my living room, not in my living room, in my parents' living room. And as I was sitting, my sister came. I was watching TV. And she came crying, you know. I was like, what happened? And she told me, you know what? Somebody beat me up. I was like, somebody beat you up? Who? She said, boyfriend. Boyfriend? You have a boyfriend? And then she told me to shut up. So I was really confused. She wanted me to help her, and she was still insulting me. You know what? Women. So, yeah. So, I was like, you know what? Who is this guy? She was like, oh, this guy, he lives in the neighborhood. Maybe you know him. I was like, okay, no problem. We're going to see him. So I went there. You know what? I was lifting weights. No, I was 17. Lifting weights. I was feeling myself, you know. So I went there. It was a bar. And I went there. And when I saw this guy, I was with my sister. She was like, I asked her, "Where's the guy?" And she was like, "It's him." I was like, "Damn, this guy is huge." He was for real. This guy, he was huge and he was tall, you know. And I was short and skinny. I thought I was big. So when I saw this guy, I was like, "Oh my God, you know what? I think we should call the police." When I told her, she was like, "The police? Really?" I was like, "Yeah, look at him. How old is he?" She was like, "He's 21. No, I was like, "No, he looks 30. Come on." And I was like, "Okay. You know what? I was thinking, I was like, whether I stay here with my sister and she will think that I won't deserve respect, you know, she won't respect me. You know, we went as a brother and sister, we may go back home as two sisters, you know?" So I was like, okay, you know what? I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna face him no matter what. So I went there. The guy was huge, I'm telling you. He was smoking and he had dreads. He looked like a gangster. So I went there, I was like, "Hey guy." He gave me, like, he greeted me. And I was like, "What is wrong with you, man?" And he was like, "Who are you?" His eyes were red. I was like, "Oh my God, I'm gonna die." For you, because he was really serious. "Who are you?" I was like, "I'm Daphne's sister." Yeah. I was like, "Yeah, no, brother, sorry. That's part of the joke too." That's part of the joke. At that point, I was like, "The sister." So, you know, yeah, I was like, "I'm Daphne's brother, you know?" Yeah, so I went there and he was like, "Oh, you're Daphne's brother." I was like, "Man, what is wrong with you?" And he was like, "Did she tell you what happened?" Actually, what happened, my sister was arguing with this guy, and this guy thought my sister was cheating on him, and he slapped my sister. Oh, I was like, "Oh my God." She told me the story, of course, but I was like, "You know what? Never raise a hand on a woman. Never do that." You know, I was feeling myself. But deep inside, I was like, "I hope he doesn't try to fight me, because I'm going to run. We're going to run." So I was like, "Never touch my sister." And he was laughing. The guy was laughing. I was like, "Okay, no problem." And I came to my sister and she was like, "What happened?" I was like, don't worry. I took charge of it." So, you know, as the big brother. And as we were going home, I was like, "You know what? Why do you date guys like that? That guy is a loser." And she looked at me and I was like, "Why can't you date an innocent Christian virgin guy like me?" And she looked at me, she was like, "Nah." That's the girl.
Yes, indeed, ladies and gentlemen, plus gentlemen and ladies. This is what we call edutainment. We educate ourselves as well as entertain ourselves here. So today we saw the scientific method. It is a systematic approach which scientists use to understand the nature of the world. Systematized means that you can find a long list of processes, but we can condense them into three. Namely, tonight we saw that they observe first and then come up with a hypothesis and then experiment with that hypothesis. And the data obtained from that experimentation serve as a basis to either accept or reject the hypothesis. And truly, the hypothesis always need to be a statement, because a question, you can't refute it. And the scientific method is on the basis that it is refutable. Now, after learning this, I tried to make very loose analogy to Toastmasters, though the program does not align with the scientific method, of course. But I do know that you can also draw loose analogy in your own life. Because I believe, after this, you are fully fresh, full-on geek, ready to legalize, apply this method in your endeavors, activity of every day of planning. Now, it is time to truly talk to you, the audience. You who are gigantic, Adan L-I-F-E, oh yes indeed, and definitely, you've shown me your attention and made me at ease on the stage, which I obviously am. And I promise you,
then I will return with a banger, a bangalific Toastmaster of the day that only me can deliver. But before I exit my stage, it is high time to acknowledge. Acknowledge the best. Acknowledge another great est. Acknowledge the fine est. Indeed, acknowledge the EST. You can name it best, fastest, greatest, where you name it, as long as you remember to add the EST of Toastmasters. Indeed, acknowledge that EST in the form of the new reminted, and to use his word, yet to be the new president of Trust Toastmasters. The floor is all yours.
Thank you so much, Raymond, for such an exhilarating meeting. Well, well conducted. All right. I'm here to close the meeting, but before we get there, I would like to get some feedback. How do you feel?
Great. Sublime.
How do you feel? Okay. How do you feel? Amazing. Amanda, how do you feel? Perfect. So I would like again to acknowledge the guests. People are here for the very first time. They're going to tell us how they feel. They're going to tell us who invited them. And they're going to tell us, of course, they will start by introducing themselves to the audience and what they liked, what they think about this, and if they're going to come back. Let me start with you, Jack. No, you can stay in your place, just, yeah.
For this opportunity, my name is Jack, and I'm here for the first time, and I was invited by Mr. Nale. He's a good friend of mine from CCR. Mm-hmm. I'd say, Mr. Jack, if you would like to join us for this meeting, I think in your public speaking, you will do the news, you're going to get something there. Once I'm
just
reached here, so the
beautiful
space is.
Oh, nice. Oh,
thank
you.
The experience I have had by sitting here, it was really nice. I learned to make the eye contact, I learned to take pause when I'm speaking, I've learned to sit and wait. Thank you so much.
All right. All right.
Good evening.
Good evening.
It's sublime to be here.
Yeah.
Yeah, my name is Sasha Kalisa, and actually it's not the first time here. But it was long. The one who invited me was Agma, but it was like 2 years. Yeah, but I was not here, and that's why I didn't come. But I like to be one member of Toastmasters, but nowadays I have the a big task that makes me to be more to engage now, but I think like after 3 months I will be a member of
this month.
Thank you very much. My name is Karate Iguani. I'm very excited.
Wow.
It's very nice to be here.
It's wonderful.
I'm surrounded by Junior, he's my brother. You guys, you have so many things that I should run. I promise that I come back. Keep doing this. It's very, very nice. It's wonderful.
Thank you
very much.
Anyone else who's here for the first time? Yes.
Thank you so much. My name is Mona Kangana. My first time being
Toastmaster of the Day was funded. And I think I'll come back. Thank you so much.
Who invited you again?
I saw a post somewhere.
All right, thank you. all right, yeah.
It's nice to be here.
It's wonderful to be here.
This was really a sublime evening. My name is Celine. It's not my first time here, but it has been a very, very long course of my study. I'm a fourth year student in the University of Rwanda doing anesthesia. So I really regret all the time lost without coming here, because this night I really had fun and I'm looking forward to coming.
All right.
Thank you.
Thank you. You know, unless you're for the first time. All right. The floor is yours.
I'm giving in by the names, and I invited the Julius. We work together with the kids every day, and I'm so excited to be here with everyone here. And I graduated in honorary senior 6, and it's so great to be with you here. And I'm still a little kid for you, but I'm very grateful kids because I'm with everybody here. And something I do really long here is that you birds speak. I just want to say, like, I want to be like you guys.
So thank you so much for visiting our clubs. Someone else? No, it's not first time.
Good evening.
Good evening.
I'm Benyam.
It's not our first time.
It's not our first time here. It's like our fifth time
here.
But it's been 6 months without coming here. We had a good evening and we want to join the club.
Okay. All right. How do you feel?
Comfortable.
Can you say one sentence to the guests?
It was definitely very nice to have you here, and I encourage you to come again. This is a great place to learn.
Alright, thank you so much. So to all the guests, we really thank you for gracing us with your presence. It's always an honor to have new faces joining us. And you are feel free to come back again. We meet every Friday right here at 6:30. It's really amazing. We are a community, we are a welcoming community, and we learn whilst having fun. And you might have heard of membership. This is a membership-based organization. So on that note, I'd like to welcome new members who recently joined our club. There are two people I want to acknowledge. The first one is, no, three people actually. The first one is Eric Guagasori in the room?
Yes, I'm here. Please.
So can you stand up together with Epiphany? So congratulations on your registrations. We welcome you and we congratulate you for taking that important step towards your self-improvement journey. And we are here as a community, especially the more experienced members, to help you through that process. And we look forward to seeing you grow. And congratulations, Epiphany, especially for also performing your very first role. It was really amazing. Thank you. I'd like also Julius to stand up. So registering is one first step, very incredible. Performing your first role is one Incredible first step, but delivering your first speech, I know he made it look easy, but trust me, it's not. It takes preparation, it takes a lot, and it takes overcoming and courage. So congratulations, we really appreciate you. Now, before I close, I would like to give one other person 2 minutes. He is our newly appointed area director. So we have a club, then a few clubs form an area, and then a few areas form a division. That's just the structure, because Toastmasters is in an international organization, and he's none other than Method Senabjo. I'd like him to come on the stage.
Thank you so much, Clément. This is a very humble man. You know, Confucius said, humility is the foundation of all virtues. And definitely, because he has that foundation, I'm sure the coming year will be very successful. Why do I say he's humble? I was sitting with him here, and I asked him, because I want to ask for the floor to say something. Do you know who is the president? He said, for this evening, it's me. Clément, congratulations. And congratulations to the whole committee, the new EXCO of TRES. Who is the head member of EXCO, the new EXCO? Just get up. We are not going to make long introductions because it will be long. Otherwise, we'll say who is playing this, which role. It will be very long. You gave me 2 minutes. Trust me, I'll just speak for 2 minutes. I would like to share this stage with Obed, if you allow me. Just 1 second. My name is Method Senabjo. I am honored and privileged to be sharing this electrical energy in this room for the next 1 year, because I'll be your area director. I'm also responsible for Kigali bilingual and for the Marvins and probably another club, because there are 2 clubs that are not yet chartered, but we hope they will be, and we hope to increase the number of clubs, because our ambition, please help us, we beg you, help us. We want Rwanda to be a division next year. Obed is also a new area director. He introduced himself within 30 seconds.
Okay, thank you very much. I'm still honored to stand in front of you. The same time I was appointed to be the ingoing, the upcoming area director of Area 9, I was appointed to be the incoming Area 8 director. It is still in Rwanda. It's about just 3-4 clubs by now. We have one Rwanda, we have TikTokers, we have NCBA and Kigali executives. So we are still here, and as he said, we are looking forward to make Rwanda a division. We are going to double the clubs which we have here in Rwanda. So I can give you a challenge as stress. Make sure you give birth to a new club in the city.
Thank you so much. So, I'm honored to be working with Tres. And looking forward to work with the new EXCO. And personally, what I find very important is 2 things, and I hope we'll get to that. Apart from the constant mission of Toastmasters, consolidate the quality of the clubs that exist and expand, create new clubs. But for me, there are 2 things that are very important. One is to have strong EXCOs. Strong committees, because I've realized when you have an executive committee that is really dynamic and hardworking, they're able to drive the club. If the committee is not strong, the club will not be guided or energized as it should be. So please help me, let's do that. And all that energy from the committee will spread into the group. That's number one. Number two, and this is new, I always ask myself, what's the use of being a member of Toastmasters? Who even sees it? Who even knows it? How does it help me? I'm not saying that everyone, the moment you register, of course, you become a great speaker and famous, no. But I'm trying to see, can we together sit down and see what the people who are already members of Toastmasters, what they can do with their talent, with their new ability. Let's think, let's work hard, have a small project, even one that doesn't generate money, but show to the outside world that what I'm learning has produced this. Look, I did this because I'm a member of Toastmasters. So those are my two ambitions, and I hope with the clubs that I'll be working with, we'll be able to achieve that. I thank you. Looking forward to working with all of you. Fantastic to always be here. Clément, Turikuni. Thank you for such an amazing, such a sublime evening, and have a nice weekend. And on that note, I declare this meeting adjourned.